FM News. On point. News on XFM. I'm Chris or Tim. Cabinet has directed the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sam Kuteesa, to engage the European Union countries regarding government's position on the activities of the Democratic Governance Facility. Last month, President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni directed the Minister of Finance to suspend the funding of DGF, and a select committee headed by the Prime Minister, Dr. Ruhakana Rugunda, was instituted to probe its funding. During a cabinet meeting held yesterday, the committee presented its report on the recommendation, but it was agreed that the Minister of Foreign Affairs first engages the funders, who are the European Union members. Information Minister Judith Nabakova explains more.
The ministry responsible for foreign affairs will be in position to tell you what was agreed upon, but I have to tell you that as cabinet, we discussed and noted all the recommendations and all the observations. So let us give time to the Minister for Foreign Affairs to interact with the EU people after their meetings, then we'll be in position to get back to us. And probably in that meeting of cabinet, that's when we shall be in position to make our final announcement as government regarding the operations of DGF in Uganda.
The opposition party GEMA has threatened not to attend the IPOD summit due to take place this Friday. On Monday, the NRM Secretary General Justin Kasule Lumumba announced that the IPOD summit will sit at Kololo and will be hosted by President Yoweri Museveni, the chairperson of the NRM, which is currently leading the IPOD, which comprises of GEMA, UPC, the FDC, DP, and the NRM. However, the spokesperson for GEMA, Sentongo Chamudu, stated that they will not attend the summit until they get answers before Friday as to why government suspended DGF, which was the lead sponsor of IPOD, and doing other activities in the country like the continuous fighting of abuse of human rights, among other issues.
We are still questioning who is funding the Friday summit when DGF was suspended. Number two, why we may not attend is because of disregard of previous resolutions by the government or by the implementing organ. We may not attend the IPOD summit because of continuous abuse of human rights. Are we going to dialogue about the military being on the streets of Kampala? What are we dialoguing about?
Parliament has halted the disbursement of over 5 billion shillings that was recently approved under the Ministry of Lands and the Uganda Land Commission to compensate different owners of land. Last month, Parliament passed a supplementary budget of over 292 billion shillings for different ministries, but before this money was passed, the Uganda Land Commission, that's the ULC, clashed with the Ministry of Lands over its decision to compensate only six people with over 20 billion shillings. The Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga, in her communication to the House of Parliament, informed MPs that she has received a petition showing an inflation on the size of land for which the funds had been approved by Parliament, and noted that these funds cannot be released without investigation. The land in question includes the 3.8 billion shillings meant to compensate Dodovico Mwanje for his land in Indeba, where the St. Peter's Church was razed down, and 1.4 billion shillings meant to compensate Geoffrey Mugisha for his land in Buyaga in Chibale. So the Minister of State for Finance, Gabriel Ajedra, presented a motion to amend a resolution of Parliament approving these funds, as the petition indicated that the land belonging to Mugisha had been inflated, while that of Dodovico Mwanje was also inflated.
This Parliament resolves to amend its resolution dated 11th of February 2021 on the supplementary schedule number 4 and addenda number 1 and 2 to the supplementary schedule number 4 for the financial year 2021.
So the Speaker noted that Parliament is going to set up an ad hoc committee to investigate the matter and ask the clerk to clear the other items in the supplementary.
So I put the question that this House do adopt the motion. Those in favour say aye, the contrary no. I serve it. So the clerk can proceed with the other items of the supplementary so that the other ministries can process their resources. And we shall set up the ad hoc committee. I'll be informing you about the composition.
The State Minister for Culture, Peace Mutuzo, has said that she is going to ask the President to direct that leaders at local levels swear in their local languages to avoid being embarrassed with broken English. Kuteesa says it is not proper for leaders to be humiliated before the people they lead by forcing them to swear in a language they are not conversant with. She made the pledge while presiding over as a guest of honor at the commemoration of the International Mother Tongue Day.
People who are struggling to swear in English, like they are going to work English in their communities. The president accepted and Akhtar was one of the persons who opposed parliament from enacting a law that bars the people who have not gone to school from contesting. Tomorrow, when I meet him, and later I'm going to meet him, I'll tell him, please, the local councils, where academic qualifications are not necessarily very important, let people speak and swear in the language they understand best.
In world news, Japanese billionaire Yasuko Maozawa has invited 8 members of the public to join him for a trip around the moon on the Elon Musk SpaceX flight. I want people from all kinds of backgrounds to join, he said in a video via Twitter, where he also shared a link to the application details. He said he will pay for the entire journey, so those who come on board will fly for free. The mission called Dear Moon is scheduled to fly in 2023. Applicants need to meet 2 criteria. They should advance whatever activity they are in to help other people and a greater society in some way, and are willing to support other crew members who share similar aspirations, he said. And that's the latest XFM News.
XFM News.